Yes, I am. Be careful. This one.
to see everything.
I'm trying. I'm trying. I know you.
down there.
Jack figured out that at Metro PCS he can get a premium phone for free. You too figure it out. Switch now and get a free big screen Samsung Galaxy. Yes, free. Get yours today. Metro PCS. Wireless figured out.
Only find on Maury right now.
Everyone, welcome Samantha to the Maury.
Backstage is the love of Samantha's life, Marvin. Nothing means more to Samantha than the family she has created with Marvin and their six-month-old son, Mason. How cute is he? So you can imagine Samantha's shock and disgust when she received this sonogram image from an unidentified woman last week, because the woman claimed that Marvin is the father of her unborn child.
This. This girl sent this sonogram to his face in his Facebook inbox.
Right.
You see what it says? Baby Mar, please be a girl.
Right.
He claims that he didn't even know. He claimed that he didn't even know the girl.
You went on Facebook and saw this, right?
Yes, it popped right up because his Facebook is messenger is logged into my phone.
Right.
It popped up on there. He claims that he doesn't know. He didn't know the girl.
Doesn't know the girl.
She's a crazy stalker. Then he admits that he does know the girl, but it can't possibly be his baby because he
never had sex with her.
Then, the night before the show, he admits that he had sex with her one time.
Oh!
If you admit it to one, you did it 30 times.
Really? Now, you all were out to breakfast, right? All of a sudden, his phone vibrated.
I had his phone in my pocket. And all of a sudden, the text message sound goes off. So, I was just going to hand him his phone. I wasn't even going to look at it.
Right.
He said, "See who it is." I look, and it said, word for word, "Marvin, did you wash my off of your
She ruined my breakfast bread. Ridiculous. How dare you? I can't wait
for his response when you show that to him. What did he say?
He doesn't know who this is. Okay,
no.
She was texting for his friend. His friend has his own cell phone. Why does she need to text yours for him? It's always something with him, and he's spending money on women? I know he's spending money on women.
Why?
Because, first of all, he left me in the hospital the night that I was having his son. He left me there. I had his son by himself. The anesthesiologist had to cut his umbilical cord
disappears a lot, right?
He disappears
all the time.
All the time. He's always gone. Sometimes he'll disappear for days at a time. He won't even answer the cell phone that I got him. Everything is he fell asleep at his family's house and all this stuff. You have your own house to come to. Why do you need to sleep somewhere else?
What'd you find in his car? Uncle, condom wrappers, perfume that I know is in mine. It's always cheap stuff. It's always something cheap.
Condom wrap.
That is a lie!
How about the glitter?
He came in the house one night. He had glitter all over the side of his face and all over his shirt. He said he came from me!
You have all this, preponderance of evidence and suspicion against him. Why do you even come here?
He called the show!
By the way, here's something else. It's not just you and him in the house. Your Uncle William lives in the house.
Yes, my uncle.
So wait a second. Let's go back here, William. You saw
him. Damn, old man.
You saw him bring women in the house.
I heard a voice coming up the steps.
Right.
So I opened my apartment to say hi to them.
Right.
And when I looked, I said, well, who's that? Oh, that's my, that's, I said, what are you stuttering about? You're who? You're who?
What'd he say? It was his cousin.
His cousin. But it took him three stutters and a mumble to get that word out.
What do you think? You think he's cheating on your niece? You think he's cheating on your niece?
Well, I think he's cheating on my niece. Yes, he's cheating on my niece. And would you cheat on her?
She's beautiful.
I'm way too pretty.
Do you like him at all?
Yeah. He's a nice guy. But he messes up.
Is he good with his son?
Yeah, he's good with his son, very good with his son. But he won't act like that with the rest of the life.
Well, guess what?
What?
We're going to see him right now. Here he is, Marvin. Marvin, come on.
Why are you doing your shit?
You love this woman.
Yes, I do, Mark.
You have a brand new little boy. Come
yes,
on.
Yes, I do. 6 months.
I know. And you're a good dad.
Yes, I am.
So you wouldn't cheat on her?
No, why would I?
Well,
I
what the heck on. Is going
you're
on?
You're such a liar. All you do is lie. You lie about
I
everything.
Made a mistake. I made a mistake. I made a
mistake. I don't believe you. Because you keep lying. Why would I keep believing a liar? You called the show to just prove to me that you're a bigger liar than I already think you are.
Okay, the sonogram. First you said it wasn't you. Then you said, okay, I slept with a girl, but that's not my baby, right?
It's not my baby, Maury. Come on, now she know that girl is a stalker.
She's not a stalker. She's stalking you because you're dealing with her. Why wouldn't she? I would be chasing you down, too, if I was pregnant with your kid.
It's not my kid.
Believe you. I believe her. You know why? Because she never lied to me. You did.
Then you believe
me. I will. And I do.
How about when you all were out for breakfast and the phone goes on vibrate and comes up
did
with
you
this
wash
text?
My off your that's a lie because I called the girl back. It was her. The same girl that sent the ultrasound picture. You just keep lying. When are you going to tell the truth?
Samantha was in the hospital giving birth. Did you ask her for $30 so you could go hook up?
Yes, I did, Maury. I asked her for
$30. Not a girl.
It just so happens that at the very same time that you asking me for $30, that this girl's asking you for $30 to sleep with her. That's just a coincidence. It's just random. Just 30 is the number of the day, right?
I guess so. By the way, I haven't even brought this up. You also think he might have done something with your sister.
What happened?
I slept with her sister. All you do is lie.
I know.
I'm not
even
here. I'm not even here.
I'm not
even here. Okay, but we
your face.
That came from her, Maury.
Everything always comes from me. It's always me.
How about the makeup and the condoms in the car?
Yeah, oh, you don't have nothing to say to that, huh?
It wasn't why I let my brother see my car.
Everything you are, your brother has his own
Mark, listen, Mark, I'm not even thinking
about
my car. As long as the person got gas money,
oh, wait, why did I need to borrow yours if they
had
their own car?
Where do you go at night when you kind of disappear?
I go out to my friend's house. You know, No, you don't get along with him. You know what he said? He said he's
trying to break up my relationship.
Everyone's always trying to break up your relationship.
Down,
you know who's breaking up your relationship? You!
A shocking hour of family members finding out the whole truth.
Everyone, welcome Jenny to the Maury Show.
Jenny married a man named Stephen, and a year later they gave birth to a beautiful boy named Stephen Jr. Now, Jenny has always felt the need to do everything in her power
to keep Stephen happy.
So,
even to the point that when Stephen invited another man into their bedroom to please her, in order to please Stephen, she reluctantly agreed. And after the deed was done, Stephen admitted it was all a test. Apparently it was a test that Jenny failed. So now Stephen not only accuses Jenny of still cheating, he denies he's the father of Stephen Jr.
When I married Stephen 4 years ago, I made a vow to love him, know him. I have never cheated on my husband. Stephen knows that I would do anything for him. So when he asked me to do his threesome, I said I had no choice because I didn't want to do it. Now he said it's all a test. He said that I failed the test and that I'm a cheater. He also says that our 3-year-old son, Stephen Jr., ain't his. I'm not a cheater. Stephen Jr. is his son. I will do whatever it takes to prove it to my husband.
Why are you so angry at him?
Because he thinks I'm a cheater. And that the baby may not be his. And I'm so angry.
What is it?
That
first of all, your baby is 3 years old.
Yes, he
is. Has he been saying this all along?
He said it. It first came out when I was pregnant with our baby. We had 2 miscarriages before our baby. So that's our miracle baby.
He actually asked you to have a threesome.
He told me that if I loved him, that I would do anything for him. So I did.
That ain't the way it was said.
It was sexual. It was oral, okay? I didn't mess with that man.
A lot of people would say oral is sexual.
Yeah, but we didn't have sex. And after that, he made me feel like I was a freaking whore.
Right.
I ain't a whore. I'm his baby's mama.
Right.
I'm his wife. And I'm tired.
Ever since after, he treated you worse after the
thing. Yes, he has. He calls me a whore every time he gets a chance to call me a whore. He tells me that I'm sleeping around or I'm giving orals all around the town and everything. I'm just sick of it.
Do you think the two of them look alike?
Oh, yes, they do. Yes, they do, Maury. Look at those eyes. Look at those eyes. Look at that chin. Maury, our son has one ear that looks like his. Okay? The other ear is my ear. Okay? That's his son. I don't have blue eyes.
Guess what? That's a first on my show. One ear looks like
yes,
me, the other
yes,
ear looks like
that's
me.
That's weird. But yeah, that's the way it is.
So you think this is all because of his own insecurity?
Yes, yes. He has trust issues. He's been hurt in the past. Okay? So he thinks I'm the same
he
as the other relationship.
He thinks he can't get a woman pregnant.
Yeah, he's trying to get this other girl pregnant.
All right, we might as well meet Steven, all right? See what he has to say.
You know he's your baby. You know that. You know that he's your baby.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, he's your baby. And you're my child.
That's not your child. I never denied my child. I denied the fact that it could be where it may not be because who did the threesome here? Was it me or was it her?
It was her.
Was it me or her?
It was her idea. You told me to do it because if I love
who ultimately has you. The decision to do it? Who ultimately has
I did it because I love you.
Oh, you love me, but yeah. You were getting on your... That's some diabolical test to put a woman through. By saying,
you may be right,
Mark. If you love me, you'll have a threesome with me.
You may be right.
And then turn on her when she tries to please you.
Yeah, well, was it really pleasing to a man to see his wife on his own or knees?
Well, all right, then, Maury.
You're wrong, Steven.
How are you going to look if she passes this test?
I'm going to look like any other man would look. I'm going to look like maybe an idiot.
I'm going to prove you wrong.
Yeah, but who else is going to look?
That Jenny was doing.
They had seen her
rumors,
out when I was
sorry, rumors. They, all these yeah. Rumors that go around town.
Shut up and let me talk here.
They're just rumors.
Shut up and let me talk. Hey, Jenny?
I'm talking to you. They're rumors, and you know that.
Yeah.
You know that.
Yeah. Well, this has to be.
So the bottom line, I assume, is if you're not the father and she's cheating, you're out.
He ain't going nowhere. He ain't going nowhere.
We're
going
to get the DNA results first. Thank you. When it comes to 3-year-old Steven Jr., Steven, you are the father. You ready for the lie detector test?
Yes, sir.
Okay. When Steven found you sweaty and out of breath, was it because you slept with another man? You said no. The lie detector test determined
you're telling the truth.
Have you had sexual contact of any kind with any other man? You said no. The lie detector test determined you are telling
me. I love you. I love you. I love you. I love you. Then I would never hurt you. I love you.
72 hours from now, Jamie is supposed to marry her fiancé, Cartonio. But there's a huge problem. Your best friend?
I don't trust them in the same room together. I don't even trust them saying hi.
Is Cartonio sleeping with Jamie's best friend, Tatiana? The results could change everything. Do you need a fraternity test? Visit DDC. Everyone, welcome Jamie to the march. Now, in 72 hours from now, Jamie is supposed to marry her fiancé, Cartonio. But there's one thing that's standing between Jamie, Cartonio, and the altar. It's Jamie's fear that Cartonio is cheating on her. You see, Jamie is afraid that one of the women Cartonio is sleeping with is her best friend, Tatiana. Your best friend? Why do you think your best friend and Cartonio are hooking up?
Because everything is about Tatiana. We could be having a whole conversation about something different and her name pops up. They're following each other on Instagram, Facebook. I'm not even her friend on Facebook or Instagram.
And they're texting each other all the time?
I asked her personally, has he been in your inbox about anything? And she said, yeah, he's inboxed me about, you know, stuff like that. But if I had it, I would screenshot it and send it to you.
Tell me how they act around each other. What's going on?
And everybody's laughing, giggling when Jamie walks in the room. Everybody quiet. You can hear a pin drop. But I'm crazy. She says it's level. It's nuts. Jamie, no, nuts crazy and then Jamie.
I see.
I guess I'm the highest.
You're the worst
level, huh?
I'm at the worst level.
I see.
Well, you shouldn't give me a reason to be at the worst level.
Right. You asked your best friend point blank, right at him. Has he come on to you?
Yes.
And what'd she say?
Yes.
She said yes.
Yes.
It's just not Tatiana, is
no,
it?
No, it's not Tatiana. And I'm not Jamie. When I don't trust them in the same room together. I don't even trust them saying hi to you.
You think he goes on Instagram and meets women?
Instagram, Facebook, Snapchat, all that.
He sent some girl a message on Valentine's Day.
Valentine's Day. We're going to Memphis for Valentine's Day. We're on our way to Memphis, Valentine's Day. He's in his girl inbox. Oh, I'm on my way to Memphis. I want to meet you at the mall so I can spend some money on you. How you spend the money on her? You spend it on me. Where did I do that part at? If that's the case, I should have invited somebody else too.
What did he say?
I'm crazy. No, I'm Jamie. You're being Jamie.
I see.
It's not nuts or crazy. You're psycho. You're
being
Jamie.
He kind of like disappears a little bit.
He disappears. He leaves. One time he told me his car fell in the ditch. The second time he told me he was so tired, he just ended up going to his mama's house, or he got locked up. But there's no reason for you to go to your mama's house if you get one. His car fell in the ditch.
Did he get it out?
Yeah, he got it out when he was ready for it to come out.
I see.
But Jamie, you're telling me all this.
Yeah.
And yet in 72 hours, you're supposed to
supposed to. Did you hear that key word? Supposed to. Supposed to.
What's going
to
happen?
He better hope and pray. He better be on his knees backstage and pray.
What happens if he fails?
Oh, I can't do it. I've been through it. I'm not doing it again. I'm too old.
This is what Cartonio had to say. What?
Listen, I'm a Scorpio. Scorpios are very sexual people. I have a very high sex drive. I want sex all day, every day, and that's why Jamie thinks I'm cheating, but I'm not cheating on her. Jamie's best friend, Tatiana, is like family to us. I've never had sex with that girl. So let me tell you something. There's nuts, there's crazy, and then there's Jamie. I love that girl, but she cannot steal fantasy from reality. Jamie needs to come back down to earth and realize that she has a good, faithful man in me.
What?
It's Cartonio. Cartoni.
It's ridiculous.
This is a good-looking couple here. Look at this.
I make him look good.
72 hours.
You're not cheating on her, are you?
Definitely not. Definitely
that's
not cheating. I wouldn't be with her if I was cheating. I wouldn't be about to be married to her if I was cheating.
Ain't nobody trying to hear none of that. That's what your mouth says.
I like this idea you talked about being a Scorpio, right? What does that
mean? And I'm a Taurus. They say that we got...
How would you describe your relationship with Tatiana?
It's just a mutual friend. That's all it is. You know, we used to work together. We stayed together. You know, we all lived together.
And what else y'all do together?
That's it. That's all it is. Nothing more. Nothing less.
Well, even Tatiana said that you came on to her.
Man, I don't know what's up with that, boy.
Maybe she acting like Jamie. Maybe she being a Jamie.
Maybe so. Two things work together.
Because of who you are and the fact that you're very outgoing, that women pay a lot of attention to.
Yeah, I can't help it.
What are you doing?
What are you doing?
Is that why you interact with so many women on social media?
No, it's just that when they comment on my pictures, they comment.
So when they find him single, we're going to see how he went then.
You wanted to take this test, didn't you?
Yeah, I called to take the test.
What about this stuff that's been found in your car?
I don't know where it came from. Everybody uses my car. She uses my car. I don't even know her.
You know I can't use that lotion. And I wear medium, not small.
I don't know where it came from.
What are you talking about?
You know, it's not every day that a guy, you know, disappears in a car and the next thing you know, it's in a ditch.
It's in a ditch.
On my way to work.
And he fell in a ditch. And the car came out when he was ready for it to come out.
When we come back, we're going to meet Tatiana, hear her story, and have the results. Yeah.
Maury are sleeping with Jamie's best friend, Tatiana. Don't dare miss these lie detector test results.
Not my baby, Maury. She know that girl is smoking.
Does he have a secret love job?
Stay tuned.
So, before the break, we met Jamie and her fiancé, Cartonio, and this couple is supposed to get married in 72 hours, but Jamie refuses to say I do until Cartonio proves he did not sleep with her best friend, Tatiana,
or any other
one.
Here's Tatiana, everybody. Welcome her.
Tatiana to talk. What were you saying, Tatiana?
I said, I'm a friendly person. I get along with everybody. When my best friend brought her man in the house, I welcome anybody in my house. I would never, why would I be a rude person? You know what I'm saying? I got to say, hospitality. I ain't going to be rude to nobody.
You just have a platonic relationship with Cartonio.
Yes, our friends, we have just like, I mean, because this is my best friend, man. I'm going to be cool with him. Why would I hate him? I
cool with everybody. I'm cool with him.
You're right. I'm cool with everybody.
She says, this friendship has been, you know, tattered because of this.
Yes, it has, and it doesn't make any sense. Out of the 15 years me and Jamie have been friends, I have never gave her a reason to not trust me. I don't even know what this is coming from.
Y'all leave, y'all leave,
y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all
leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave,
y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave,
y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave,
y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave,
y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave,
y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave,
y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all
leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all
leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all
leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all
leave, y'all leave,
y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all
leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all leave, y'all
broke up. It was in a relationship. At the end of the day.
Brandy is pregnant with Travis's baby.
6 months pregnant.
Is the man she's about to marry a cheater?
What's going to happen if he fails?
I'm going. I
Plus, not my baby. Why would you know that girl was fucking?
Does he have a secret love job? The answer is coming up.
In a city this size, criminals walk among us.
In a shocking hour of family members finding out the whole truth.
Everyone welcome Brandy to the bar.
Brandy is 6 months pregnant. She's excited to start a family with her fiancé, Travis. But sadly, Travis has a scandalous past as a ladies' man. And apparently that has come back to haunt them both. You see, 7 days ago, Brandy discovered Travis was sending nude photos of himself to other women. So now Brandy wants to know if Travis is a changed man or is he just a leopard who hasn't changed his spots? Watch.
I'm 6 months pregnant, and I want this baby to have his mama and his dad. But I cannot stay with a man that is cheating. This is killing me. I feel like my heart is breaking in a million pieces. Travis was a womanizer when I met him. We were friends first, so I thought he wouldn't do that to me. But I fell in love with him. And I trusted Travis. I felt betrayed when I caught him sending new photos to other women. That's what he used to send to me. If he fails his lie detector test, I don't know what's going to happen to our family.
You're so upset about this.
We have a baby on the way. I mean, and if he's cheating, then I don't need to be with him.
He says he's a changed man because of his love for you.
I mean, if he was, then I wouldn't have found nude pictures of other women on his phone. And, I mean, he wouldn't be sending nude pictures on chat sites. He wouldn't even be on a chat site.
We might as well find out what Travis has to say. Here he is. Travis, come on out.
You know you cheated.
You know, I'm always interested in this because, you know, I believe people can change.
Oh, yes.
You were a very flirtatious guy. You used to be with a lot of women.
Maury, I was single and I was living my life. I was doing exactly what I
and
wanted to do.
And then you brought it over into this relationship,
you know?
Too. Because
so,
if
yeah,
you wasn't, you wouldn't be okay.
Why are you sending nude photos of your bride?
Man, we were broken up, Maury.
We were broken up, but we were still talking on the phone, though.
So,
that's not really broken up. That's trying to
get back together. But I wasn't even sending pictures. I was just posting.
I mean, that's not working things out. I mean, that's working things out.
We're going to find out right now. Did you sleep with any of the women you sent explicit photos to?
No.
You said no. The lie detector test determined you're telling the truth. Relationship with Brandy, have you slept with any of the women you text message with? You said no. The lie detector test determined you're telling the truth. During your relationship with Brandy, have you had sexual contact of any kind with any other woman?
No.
You said no. The lie detector test determined you're telling the truth.
Sorry. You called me crazy. I don't know what I'm talking about.
Another woman sent Marvin a sonogram photo. He swears he can explain.
Not my baby. Marvin, come on. Now she know that girl is talking.
There's someone else here. I'm furious and fed up. Yes, he's cheating on my niece. The results are nasty. And what happens after this lie detector test is unbelievable.
Attention, if you've had an hour of family members finding out the whole truth.
Nothing means more to Samantha
than the family she has created with Marvin and their six-month-old son, Mason.
This girl sent this sonogram to his face, in his Facebook inbox. The night before the show, he admits that he had sex with her one time.
Oh, it's not just you and him in the house. Your Uncle William lives in the house.
Yes, my uncle.
I think he's cheating on my niece. Yes, he's cheating on my niece.
You wouldn't cheat on her. No, why would I? First you said it wasn't you. Then you said, okay, I slept with a girl, but that's not my baby, right?
It's not my baby, Maury.
But I believe her. You know why? Because she never lied to me.
You also think he might have done something with your sister.
He said as he was walking off, that's why I slept with your sister. I've been talking to her.
We're ready for the result.
I'm not there.
During your relationship with Samantha, did you get another woman pregnant? You said no. The lie detector determined you are telling the truth.
One question.
When you disappear at times, is it because you're sleeping with other women? You said no. The lie detector determined that was a lie. Did you sleep with another woman while Samantha was pregnant? You admitted to our lie detector administrator.
Exactly.
Did you leave Samantha at the hospital to go sleep with another woman? You admitted to our lie detector.
And finally,
Marvin, are you using Samantha's money on other women? You said no. The lie detector test determined that was a lie.
The lie detector's a lie, right? You left me in the hospital to go sleep with somebody else. How dare you? You don't have nothing to say, do you? Right? You don't never have nothing to say.
You have a family together. What's going to happen here? Come on.
I don't know, Maury. That's too much.
My name is Steams.
You gonna keep doing the same thing. Like, how many times can you make the same mistake?
There's no more mistakes.
It doesn't make no sense. Why you keep doing this to me?
Well, I'm willing to start over. That's why I came there. I want to start over. I want to be a family again.
You said you called the show to prove that you wasn't lying, but you lied about everything.
You know why he really called the show? He knew what was going to happen, and he wanted a chance at a new beginning. Is that right?
Yes. I actually want you to sit down and talk to me. I know I messed up. I made a lot of mistakes in my life, you know. I just want to turn over a new leaf.
You say that all the time.
Tell you what we'll do, okay? Because there's a child involved here and everything else. We'll check up 6 months from now. We'll see how true blue he's been, alright?
Yes.
You said yes. Thank you. She said yes. You deserve it. You deserve it. Better me.
CPAC or this insane address to Congress. And most importantly, they are useless. They add nothing to the safety of this country. They are sadistic. They are turning ordinary, unthinking Americans into a mindless Gestapo. Donald Trump's Gestapo. When you detain an American born in Philadelphia and ask him over and over again, where did you get your name from? And are you Muslim? And the man's name is Muhammad Ali Jr. It's a Muslim ban. When ICE agents reportedly wait across the street from a Virginia church refuge designed to save the homeless from freezing to death on our streets, and you grab six men as they leave the place, it is a purge of Hispanics. When an apparent white supremacist reportedly asks two engineers from India in a bar in Kansas City about their visas, then allegedly shoots them while shouting, "Get out of my country," and Sean Spicer says that the thought of it having anything to do with Trump is, quote, absurd, it's a Muslim ban. When you end a program designed to prevent the deportation of spouses and parents and children of active U.S. military personnel, it is a purge of Hispanics. When you tell the Oregon family of a four-month-old girl that no matter who approved what when, she is initially denied entry to Portland for life-saving surgery because she's from Iran, it's a Muslim ban. When you go into a Texas courtroom and you grab a victim of domestic abuse who was there getting a restraining order, and the tip may have come from the alleged domestic abuser, it is a purge of Hispanics. When you detain a 70-year-old woman and interrogate her at LAX for 2 hours because somebody somewhere thinks there's something wrong with her American-issued visa when there isn't, and she turns out to be the author of children's books with titles like Possum Magic and With Love at Christmas, and her name is Marion Mem Fox, and this is her 117th trip to this country, and she says it's the first time she has ever been questioned, let alone interrogated, it's a Muslim ban. When you allegedly detain a Mexican man at the border, and even though he is in apparent emotional distress, deport him again anyway, and he goes to a bridge, a few hundred feet into Mexico, and he throws himself to his death. It is a purge of Hispanics. When you ignore the report from the Department of Homeland Security that the ban on travel from the seven countries will likely do nothing to enhance American security, it's a Muslim ban. When you seize a man being released on bail and detain him for nearly 3 days, and you tell him he is an illegal immigrant and you are going to deport him, and you don't care that his birth certificate and state ID say he is from Puerto Rico, which is part of the goddamn United States of America, it is a purge of Hispanics. When you detain a historian, a visiting scholar at Texas A&M and formerly at Harvard and Dartmouth for 10 hours because he was born in Cairo, Egypt, 62 years ago, and he was coming here to speak about the French Vichy government that collaborated with the Germans in World War II and how all those lessons have been forgotten, it is a Muslim ban that now tracks directly back to the Nazis.
Right.
And when you propose loosening employment requirements for hiring new border agents, congressionally mandated requirements, loosening background checks, loosening the use of polygraph tests, loosening entrance examinations, and when you tell passengers on board a domestic flight from San Francisco to New York that they need to produce, quote, their papers, or they will not be allowed to get off the plane because you're looking for somebody who has a deportation order against them, it is no longer just a Muslim ban or just a purge of Hispanics. It is a series of acts intended to terrify Americans into submission. It is a series of acts intended to silence those who would object and turn them into human sheep. It is a series of acts intended to turn respect for authority into fear of authority. It is a series of acts intended to give the rank and file customs and ICE employees both the false sense that they are still doing something moral and an appetite for sadism and brutality on which authoritarianism feeds. It is, in fact, a series of acts of terrorism against the people of the United States of America. And Donald Trump, it is your doing, and in due time, you will atone. Resist. Peace.
live TV. Live TV.
Thank you. This is going to slow the evolving process starting around 2009 when shirts on. I've been an arrest reporter for about 10 years here in this building. I work over here on the far side, which is the Senate side. So I kind of have a general understanding of the way that the House and the Senate work. Before that, I had a number of assault occupations, which I talked about in the So what are Democrats going to be doing in the chamber? This is going to be empty because Donald Trump loves and rally environment because it feeds his insatiable need for adulation. This is going to be one of the worst times that he's in a situation where half is standing in a chair for him and the other half is sitting on their hands quiet, and some of them begging me to do some low level appropriate activity.
You didn't.
That's uses his power.
Thank you.
is it? It's really. Thank you. Does it mean to trans? Interested. Not gone.
Video games are a $99.6 billion industry. Yeah, Equity Arcade is in the business of making sure everyone can get a piece of that action. You see, with traditional crowdfunding sites, backers get rewarded with gifts like a free t-shirt or maybe early access to a game. With Equity Arcade, it's not a donation. It's a certified investment. And our website makes it simple to get started. Signing up takes less than a minute. So let us be the first to welcome you into the new era of crowdfunding.
It's kind of cool. I didn't know what to use this morning. I was looking for I always look for a sunset or a sunrise, typically. Sometimes I look for natural stuff. This is in Canada. This is permafrost. That's not so perma anymore. This is melting and sinking permafrost, which is releasing massive amounts of methane. It's been trapped in the soil for thousands of years. And that absolutely, definitely does increase greenhouse gases. That's not good. Right? That's just not good. That's not right. Good morning, everybody. We've got Markus here with us today. And morning, Markus. How you doing?
I'm fine. Thank you. How are you, John?
I'm all right. I'm excited. So many things are happening at the same time, and you know, I'm like freaking out about all of them, and I got to tell everybody about it. And good things going on. Good. Yeah. I think we found a good place for Donald. And he's covering his own stuff, so should be good there. Shouldn't be as distracting. Anyway, we got. What was? Did you watch the speech last night, Markus? Did you get a chance to watch? I did.
But not the whole thing. I only watched 30 minutes, and yes, it was astounding to see 45 saying all these warm and sweet words. But I think it was yesterday, and today is another day. Let's see what happens today.
I agree, and he did a nice job. Yes, he did a nice job of putting on that show, which is what we were expecting. That was the first time he was presidential, according to everybody else. He put on the show. Well, we're going to talk about that. Good morning, everybody. We got Jonathan and Metalhead and Melissa and Robert, and Joanne and Density, Kevin and Charles. Hey, Charles. Rose Toes, Kendra. Oh, sit here. You go, Sutra. Robert. Good morning, Morfron. Manic DBV. Ellis Ray. So many people. Stock Post.
So many.
Al Walski. If I missed you, I'll catch you later. Thank you so much for being here, everybody. Thank you. I got all sorts of exciting news, all right? Thank you all to patrons. I know it's about to take your money, or they already took your money, and so thanks. Patreon is giving me money now. Actually, what they do is they collect it, and then they don't tell me anything about it. And then I log in there, and it's like, oh, look at here. Here's where I can send myself the money. That's what I just did yesterday. So either way, it's working. It seems to be functioning now, so I'm very thankful for that. So everybody who was wondering what the hell's happening with your actual contributions, I am receiving them, and they are going towards wonderful things, including growing what's back here. Anyway, the cover card picture was from Wikimedia, by the way. That is, that's just one place where permafrost is really just sinking, right? Siberia doing the same thing. As a matter of fact, Siberia has one of the biggest. They're uncovering a 10,000-year-old forest. That's how fast it's moving and how deep it is. And it's really cool. They're like, here's a mammoth, here's a bunch of petrified forest, here's stuff that we haven't seen forever. And I'm thinking to myself, all the microbes and other things that have been trapped in there that are now getting released into the air that can survive being in there, that are going to reinfect the environment. And it'll be interesting to see what happens with all that. We are. Somebody in chat said to me, that, you know, this is all happened before. This is typical Earth warming. I think it was a climate denier. They're saying, you know, everybody needs to stop being quite an alarmist. I'm like, maybe this is, yes, this does happen, right? This global warming and cooling generally over hundreds of thousands of years, not in a decade or 100 years, right? Nobody seems to understand that, yes, this happens, but not like this, not this fast. I was watching the weather. I know we're going to talk about Trump and shit, but we're talking about the picture for a minute. But the Weather Channel was reporting, just they call them tornado outbreaks now. When I was growing up, there were not tornado outbreaks. Now it's like acne. We have a severe tornado outbreak across this piece of the Midwest. It's a blizzard or whatnot, and we've got tornadoes. People don't understand, and they're just, the Weather Channel perpetuates this, that's just weather. It's just called extreme now. How many years does it go on before it's not extreme? It's just normal weather. And they normalize this instead of like relating it to climate change, which they still don't do. They don't do it all. They romanticize the severity of the storms. And the reason I'm bringing that up is because of what Trump did last night in his speech, which was to romanticize the violent deaths, the sacrifice of soldiers in the interest of making himself look presidential. And what he did last night has been done by every president, basically, to justify death, to justify a war. But we're going to listen to, we've got some other opinions. I want to start with Keith Olbermann. I used to be a big fan of Keith Olbermann when I really wasn't quite an awake American, but I was an angry American. And I didn't really understand what, you know, rah, but I didn't understand how to take my anger, do anything with it. And Keith was a great ranter. I probably learned ranting skills somewhat from Keith, just from watching him. Not that I emulate his passivity. He's very good at staying, remaining calm, and right. I can't do that. So, but let's listen to Keith, because he just kind of he said it. I think he says it perfectly. How we all feel about Trump, his Muslim ban, his Hispanic exodus, whatever you want to call it. It's just ridiculous. This sums it up for me. Hope it works for you.
I'm Keith Olbermann, and this is The Resistance. Trump's travel ban is a Muslim ban, and his immigration enforcement order is a purge of Hispanics. And I am tired of hearing the radical right bullshit that they are anything else. And I do not believe a word about them coming out of this racist's mouth, whether it's CPAC or this insane address to Congress. And most importantly, they are useless. They add nothing to the safety of this country. They are sadistic. They are turning ordinary, unthinking Americans into a mindless Gestapo. Donald Trump's Gestapo. When you detain an American born in Philadelphia and ask him over and over again, where did you get your name from? And are you Muslim? And the man's name is Muhammad Ali Jr. It's a Muslim ban. When ICE agents reportedly wait across the street from a Virginia church refuge designed to save the homeless from freezing to death on our streets, and you grab six men as they leave the place, it is a purge of Hispanics. When an apparent white supremacist reportedly asks two engineers from India in a bar in Kansas City about their visas, then allegedly shoots them while shouting, "Get out of my country," and Sean Spicer says that the thought of it having anything to do with Trump is, quote, absurd, it's a Muslim ban. When you end a program designed to prevent the deportation of spouses and parents and children of active U.S. military personnel, it is a purge of Hispanics. When you tell the Oregon family of a four-month-old girl that no matter who approved what when, she is initially denied entry to Portland for life-saving surgery because she's from Iran, it's a Muslim ban. When you go into a Texas courtroom and you grab a victim of domestic abuse who was there getting a restraining order, and the tip may have come from the alleged domestic abuser, it is a purge of Hispanics. When you detain a 70-year-old woman and interrogate her at LAX for 2 hours because somebody somewhere thinks there's something wrong with her American-issued visa when there isn't, and she turns out to be the author of children's books with titles like possum magic and with love at Christmas, and her name is Marion Mem Fox, and this is her 117th trip to this country, and she says it's the first time she has ever been questioned, let alone interrogated. It's a Muslim ban. When you allegedly detain a Mexican man at the border, and even though he is in apparent emotional distress, you deport him again anyway, and he goes to a bridge a few hundred feet into Mexico, and he throws himself to his death. It is a purge of Hispanics. When you ignore the report from the Department of Homeland Security that the ban on travel from the seven countries will likely do nothing to enhance American security, it's a Muslim ban. When you seize a man being released on bail and detain him for nearly 3 days, and you tell him he is an illegal immigrant and you are going to deport him, and you don't care that his birth certificate and state ID say he is from Puerto Rico, which is part of the goddamn United States of America, it is a purge of Hispanics. When you detain a historian, a visiting scholar at Texas A&M and formerly at Harvard and Dartmouth, for 10 hours because he was born in Cairo, Egypt, 62 years ago, and he was coming here to speak about the French Vichy government that collaborated with the Germans in World War II and how all those lessons have been forgotten, it is a Muslim ban that now tracks directly back to the Nazis. And when you propose loosening employment requirements for hiring new border agents, congressionally mandated requirements, loosening background checks, loosening the use of polygraph tests, loosening entrance examinations, and when you tell passengers on board a domestic flight from San Francisco to New York that they need to produce, quote, their papers, or they will not be allowed to get off the plane because you're looking for somebody who has a deportation order against them, it is no longer just a Muslim ban or just a purge of Hispanics. It is a series of acts intended to terrify Americans into submission. It is a series of acts intended to silence those who would object and turn them into human sheep. It is a series of acts intended to turn respect for authority into fear of authority. It is a series of acts intended to give the rank and file customs and ICE employees both the false sense that they are still doing something moral and an appetite for sadism and brutality on which authoritarianism feeds. It is, in fact, a series of acts of terrorism against the people of the United States of America. And Donald Trump, it is your doing, and in due time, you will atone. Resist. Peace.
Well, I'm not sure which is more awesome, Keith's speech, which I like and agree with every word he had to say, or your reaction, which is wholly different from what I was expecting, guys. I think you spent the majority of the time dissing on Keith. And I'm not sure where somebody could say, Froze, you said what Keith has to say is horseshit? I don't get it, guys. What the hell? How many of you actually spent time listening to the long list of things? What Keith did, very beautifully, if you were paying attention, I'm not sure any of you were actually paying attention, what Keith did was, and I'm speaking specifically to those in chat, for those of you that come by later and listen to this as a podcast, you know, think of what you want. But the chat is spending much of their time complaining about Keith Olbermann and not really listening to what is actually being said by Keith Olbermann. Keith has listed a number of the things that I was trying to put together. What he did was put cohesiveness to the number of violations of constitutional rights, of human rights, that have been perpetrated by law enforcement, by ICE holes, by Border Patrol agents. This is not normal. I don't know why you guys are fucking caring about who Keith is and what you think of him and his past stuff and his rants and whatnot. But we just had a list of how our country is acting like fucking Gestapo, like Nazis. Detaining people who don't even... Detaining a redheaded white woman from Australia. I don't think you guys understand just how fucking scary that is. This is the crossover between Muslim ban, Hispanic purge, and dissident. Are you a dissident of the state? Do you not believe in Trump and what Donald Trump, what 45 is doing? Let me see your papers. That's exactly what the fuck is going on here, folks. People of prominence that have spoken out against the United States policies are getting pulled aside in this picking and choosing of human beings. I don't think you guys understand just how fucking scary that is. Those of you who are looking at this as a what you guys are calling it. It's an armchair resistance, all right? I will say this. Keith Olbermann has a reach far beyond anything I got. Keith Olbermann actually has a reach probably far beyond what TYT has, what Jordan Cheriton has in a normal day. So when Keith Olbermann speaks, despite what you guys think of his ass, he actually has an effect, a big, massive effect. So he is effective. He is doing things for the resistance. My God, you guys. I am watching my nation turn into Nazi fucking Germany. It's not identical. It's doing it in the way America does things best. Let's act horrific and paint a nice picture.
Yes, you will.
And that's what's so scary about it. Other nations, when Germany started acting the way it was in the 30s, they had years of, well, we're not really sure. We're not really sure. And then, boom, all of a sudden, oh, fuck yeah. And it's almost like that's what's happening here in some ways. Well, America's acting like assholes, but they're going to paint a pretty picture. Look at last night with the crying woman and the soldier story and Trump looking all patriotic. That's exactly what he needs to do to sell this shit. That's how America sells wars. We use our soldiers and then we use their families to justify our horrific action. And right now we're using that to justify selectively banning human beings from coming into our country and selectively kicking out human beings. It's frightening. It's absolutely frightening. And that's what you need to be paying attention to, quite frankly. Just gonna say.
Well, I think Keith Olbermann, it was a good presentation, and I think he nailed it, and I don't see the criticism about him. But, okay, I don't know him. It was the first time I saw this on a clip, and but I have to agree with what he says, because it is very frightening. If I only can see what is happening in some states, that there are people in jail without getting access to a lawyer or something else, this is, in my opinion, unthinkable. You know, what happened all around the Dakota Access Pipeline?
Yes,
it is unthinkable that a state would act like this in Germany, for example. Okay, it might be broad Germany again, but in Germany, there would be a lawyer who with state legacy, and they would tell you, no, fuck you, this is not working here. They would lose their jobs. They wouldn't come to the idea to do such a thing.
Yeah.
And I think it is worrying to see, and I think Olbermann is right in many parts. Maybe he's a little bit too much into the Nazi thing, but you cannot close your eyes. What's going on?
Well, they're saying it's because he lost his cred with the whole Russia thing. And I go, so
hey, I don't know about the Russia thing. I don't know.
Well, the Russia thing, everybody does the Russia, oh, the Russian interference with the Russian hacking. He went down that road with a lot of people.
Yeah, yeah.
And so,
you okay, know. I don't know. I'm just referring to what he just said in this clip.
Yeah,
you know?
Me too.
I only can agree.
Me too. That's why I'm bringing up that point right there, is because you guys are like, well, Olbermann said this about Russia. You know, is that it? Remember, we're human beings, right? So is Keith Olbermann a bad human being now because he decided he was going to take a stand in one direction on Russia and when what he thought about it? That's what I don't get. It's like we are so quick to judge. You guys prejudge a lot. I prejudge. I'm not saying you guys would. It's part of American culture. We are prejudiced instantly, immediately. Like, we seek a reason. Ah, fuck Keith. He said something stupid I didn't like 2 months ago about something. That doesn't delegitimize anything Keith has to say today. He had an opinion, right? He had an opinion and a perspective. Today, we listen to a different opinion and perspective. You know why? Because time moves forward. Things fucking change. So, I just, you know, anyway. I've been looking at your comments. Something just kicked on louder than normal, and I have no idea what that is. You guys can probably hear it, and I'm going to have to, Zox, I'm doing my best to try to read everything you guys are saying, but it's very difficult to try to fly back up and see, all right? I'm just pointing out my personal opinion on the whole thing and why I played the clip, and I was just surprised that you guys spent an awful lot of time thinking about Keith and not about what team. And yeah, we just dipped for a second, guys. Actually, John, I'm not human and never prejudge. I post-judge, though. Really? So now I've got a... So are you... You're not human. Interesting. Well, we've got quite an audience diversity there. Very interesting. All right. Moving on. Meanwhile, outside of Trump's speech, this was going on, guys. Podcast crowd. For those of you who are wondering why the hell you just heard a whole bunch of pots, pats, pans clanging and people chanting, it's because you were watching a video from Rupley about what was going on outside of the wherever the hell he was speaking. I don't know where he was speaking last night. Wherever they meet, Congress, White House, that place, the wherever they were. This is a march. Actually, it's still going on. They're marching right here. The reason I'm showing you this is because this didn't used to happen in America, right? Not like that. Every once in a while, a bunch of angry people would get together and do something, but not constantly. It's been constant, right? And that's what's so awesome, is that we are now relentless, and it's having a massive effect. By the way, I found the nice quote that Joanne I Am put in here, "Everyone is a prisoner of his own experiences. No one can eliminate prejudices. Just recognize them." Edward R. Murrow. And that's true. But once we recognize them, we should be able to adjust, do something about them, right? In the moment, whatever it is I'm being prejudiced about, that's part of eliminating. That's part of the beauty of human, right? Is that we can adjust our software in real time. Where are you guys at? And if I were going to be anything, I'd be a Muppet, not a puppet. What do you say, Markus?
Socks is very interesting what he has to say. We are close to be occupied by a hostile force. And I have seen the enemy, and it is us.
Yeah.
And this is there's a true point in it.
There
it's,
is.
It's absolutely right. Yes.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, the enemy is us. The enemy is the people we've elected to represent us at a federal level, and in some cases a state level. Right. But it's not all bad. It's not all bad. We're making progress. I promise. I'm going to show you proof of progress. Big, huge crowds have power. Absolutely, Zox. Small crowds have power. You know how I know small crowds have power? It's all relative to where you need the power. You need 250,000 people to show up at the Washington Mall to look effective. Trump learned this the hard way. Because, you know, he had a small inauguration comparatively, right? It's very, very small. Like his hand, small. But when you take 500 people and bring them to Macon City, Iowa, and you go to the town hall in Macon City, Iowa, with Tom Feagan, a Senate candidate, and you say, you're not going to build another hog farm factory slaughterhouse here in our town and make us pay for it, then you stop your town from doing something. That's what it took in Macon City, 500 people. That's not a lot of people. Maybe that's a lot of people for Macon City. All right. So it's all relative, folks. You want to make a big splash in your town, figure out what that number is. The more the merrier, obviously, but, you know, 500 people stopped the town mayor and city council and all those people from doing something wrong and corrupt. That's how many people it took to intimidate the town mayor of Macon. Think about that. Think about that. John going into private prison for something he said in episode 3. Exactly. Exactly. Yeah. That's what we're looking at here. I laugh at the idea simply because I consider this effort to be small and our reach to be small and relatively insignificant comparatively to something like TYT or Democracy Now, right? I expect Amy Goodwin to end up in jail before I do. But then again, you never know. I tweet some seriously nasty shit to Trump every once in a while. I actually had Twitter tell me the other day that I was... I don't know what they did, but I was limited in my posting because I said some bad things. So, you know, who knows? That's the Trump call is creeping you out. At least you can't see his wiener. It's a family show.
The dog creeps you out and not the original 45.
Yeah, no kidding. It's beyond that now. It's what did you say in your room when the gov recorded you? Oh, yeah. No, all of this is recorded. You guys know I say hi to the NSA. Hi, NSA. Glad to talk to you. I say all sorts of things, rants, at the NSA in the morning before I even go live. Just like, hey, guys, I know you're listening. Here's all the crazy shit that you want to hear. I mean, trust me. Absolutely. I'm ready. I'm waiting for it. It's better to be prepared. All right, we're gonna move on with the show because we got a lot of stuff to talk about and I want to get to it. I want to make sure I have a good list. We did Olbermann, Law 45 blathers on. All right, I saw this. I didn't hear this. If I play the video, it's Trump basically talking about how he drained the swamp, which is absolutely ludicrous. But this headline says the Dems heckle Trump's drain the swamp line. I don't hear it.
I do.
Did you hear them heckle? Could you hear it on live TV? Okay, so they really did?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I'm not going to play it because here's the thing. Like, that matters. I mean, they have no power. Oh, they heckled him. Ooh. It's when we talk about, you know, armchair politicians, is what I'm thinking of. It's politicians that do that. They have no problem booing and cheering and you know, a lot of talk. Where's their action? I want to know where their action is. What are they doing beyond that? Right? I know what Bernie Sanders is doing, and he's about the only one. All right, I know what Peter DeFazio is doing, because we got footage of him. What are the other people doing? What are they really doing besides avoiding town halls? Right?
Look, Congress, how many percent should we get rid of them? How many percent should be even sitting there?
Well, we have a good chance to get rid of a lot of them. Most of them, right?
Yeah, exactly.
I had an article from Joe Manchin, right? Manchin bagged on Bernie Sanders at the recent town hall, and they handed him his ass. And he said, well, then you should vote me out if you don't agree with me. He literally said this. I am not going to change. If you don't like me, vote me out. That's it. Thank you, Joe. Thank you for explaining how democracy works. We forgot. We're on that. We'll get rid of you in 2018. You better fucking believe we'll get rid of Joe Manchin, who bags on Bernie Sanders, who bags on the ACA, because you know why? Oh, my CPU is overheating. That's a great freeze. That stays there. I don't know what's going on with... Oh, I know why. Shit. This is my bad. There. Should be a lot better now. I had Markus up here full frame over here. It's crazy. Trump is gold. Just think. 2018 is only 1 year away. Now is the time. Now is the time to find a candidate local to you that is running that you respect and help support them. Now is the time to find out how you can be involved in any continuing candidates, right? Like Peter DeFazio, how can I make sure that Peter stays in? Because I like Peter now, right? I've heard him speak. I have some trust in Peter. I got trust in Jeff Merkley. I want to make sure that my top dogs in this state that I give a shit about stay, right? And what can I do in my local town? Who's going to run? Charles Mon, what are you going to run for? And Justin Bryce, what are you going to run for? And any of you other people, what are you going to run for? And you can come on this show, and we'll help you run, and we'll do interviews with you, and we'll create segments for you, right? I'm excited that Joe and many other Democrats, at least, the Republicans, I don't know what they're going to do, that many other Democrats understand that their ass is on the line, and I think many of them are like, fine, I'm happy to go. I don't want any part of this new thing going on here. And that's great, right? Guys like Joe don't want to change. The guys like Joe can go find another job. That's all. It's just a job, right? Yeah. Manchin is protected from the people he represents. He is protected because, and you agree, Charles, John, Jeff, and Jeff and Peter are fantastic. Yeah, I don't know about Wyden yet. Not sure about Wyden. 2017 municipal election. See, I don't even know about that. There's that too. See, it's very electing people in the United States market is very complicated. They've made it so convoluted and complicated because they don't want people participating. They don't, you know, it's so much easier. You heard the Republicans. Shit, if more people vote, we're going to lose. Right? So.
Yeah. And wasn't there the town hall? Was it Republicans? The senator or congress member didn't appear, and they put a chicken on the desk instead of himself and held it in the town hall?
Yes,
Was that something?
Yeah, I don't know who. Somebody sent me a note about that. I don't know who it was. I want to thank you all. So many comments have come in, and like Springfield and Rob, and I can't even list all the names. You guys are sending me so many links, things, and stuff, and I've tried to respond in YouTube's. And yes, somebody said that they put a chicken. That's beautiful. I love it. I love it. That is exactly the kind of nonviolent, you know, that's direct action that has so much of an effect. You don't understand the ripple effect that this has, right?
And they are so scared.
Yeah.
They are so scared. There's another senator or congress member, I don't know, who is doing now a tele-town hall. So the people can go by internet when he has his town hall in his home or somewhere, you know, because he's afraid to leave them.
Wow. Yeah. And I mean, here's the thing, though. That could be turned into a beautiful experience. A virtual town hall is what I'm trying to create for our folks here, right? They would still be somewhere physical and still have an audience, but I can bridge that with engagement with folks online, right? That's
as an addition, yes.
Right. That was the original goal, was to say, now I can sit at home on my computer if I can't get to the town hall, or if it only holds 400 people, now 40,000 could watch, right? And it doesn't require any more gear than what most people have. That's the difference. Where you, before, you know, a city would have to have a studio and all this gear and all this shit. Now you don't have to do that. I want to provide that to our politicians and everybody running for office here around me, so that we have an advantage over the establishment, an advantage over the Republicans. Right? This is part of winning the war. This is part of what it takes, which is a great lead-in. Okay, here's the thing. I want to play Bernie's way far into this. I have a very we're going to play Bernie's reaction to Trump. I just want to play that right now, and then we're going to get into some other stuff that's really exciting. It's 14 and a half minutes, though. All right, so bear down. Those of you podcasting, listen to this later's podcast. You're going to hear 14 and a half minutes of Bernie uninterrupted. It's going to be beautiful, and we're just going to let it go. And I don't want to hear any complaints. I didn't complain. This Bernie, man. Just kidding. You are welcome to your opinions. All right, we're going to do this. When we come back, I'm going to tell you some really exciting news about the truth against the machine that I was talking about yesterday. This is really, really, really cool, and I'm very excited about it. And then we're going to show you some really cool shit that Ashley made. But first, let's all relax, grab that doobie, sit down, go get a cup of tea or coffee or whatever you're drinking. You know, when I was unemployed, I was drinking other things early, so whatever you're doing. And let's go. It's not that you're all unemployed. Here we go. Bernie Sanders.
Good evening. Before I respond to President Trump's speech and what he said tonight, I wanted to say a few words about what he didn't say, because when you analyze the speech, sometimes what is more important is what somebody does not say as opposed to what they actually say. Some examples. At a time when over half of older Americans have no retirement savings, I did not hear President Trump say one word, not one word, about Social Security or Medicare. During the campaign, as we all remember, President Trump promised over and over and over again that he would not cut Social Security, Medicare, or Medicaid. It was a cornerstone of his campaign. But in his first address to the nation, he didn't even mention Social Security or Medicare once, not a single time. Even worse, President Trump has proposed a massive cut to Medicaid. Massive cut, threatening the nursing home care of millions of senior citizens and the health care of many, many of our children. I urge President Trump, keep your promises. Tell the American people, tweet to the American people, that you will not cut Social Security, Medicare, and Medicaid. Further, I did not hear President Trump tonight mention the words income and wealth inequality, or the fact that we now have the widest gap between the very rich and everyone else since the 1920s. I did not hear President Trump mention the fact that as a result of the disastrous Citizens United Supreme Court decision, a 5-4 decision, we now have a corrupt campaign finance system that is allowing billionaires to buy elections and undermine American democracy. How could you give a speech to the nation and not talk about that enormously important issue? Furthermore, not only did President Trump not mention the issue of voter suppression, what Republican governors are doing all over this country to make it harder for people to participate in our democracy, but the truth of the matter is, his administration is now working overtime with Republican governors to make it harder for young people, low-income people, senior citizens, and people of color to vote. That is an outrage. Perhaps most astoundingly, at a time when the scientific community is virtually unanimous in telling us that climate change is real, that it is caused by human activity, that it is already causing devastating problems in our country and all over the world, I did not hear President Trump say one word, not one word, about the need to combat climate change, the greatest environmental threat facing our planet. Not only did he not mention climate change, he pledged to increase our dependency on fossil fuels. Furthermore, at a time when we have more people in jail than any other country on earth, disproportionately African American, Latino, Native American, I did not hear President Trump say one word about how he was going to fix a broken criminal justice system. Yes, we must support the hard work of men and women in the police departments and the sheriff's departments all over this country. But we must end also the disgrace of having more people in jail than any other country on earth. Furthermore, at a time when we need the best educated workforce in the world to compete in a highly competitive global economy, I did not hear President Trump say one word, not one word, about the need to lower the cost of college and to do what countries all over the world are doing, and that is to make public colleges and universities tuition-free. It's an enormously important issue, impacting millions of families throughout this country. Not one word about making colleges more affordable, not one word about addressing the crisis of student debt. During his campaign, President Trump told us that he was going to take on Wall Street and drain the swamp. Remember that? He was going to drain the swamp. Well, the swamp, big time, is now in his administration, which has more millionaires and billionaires than any presidential administration in history. Amazingly enough, for somebody who was going to drain the swamp, who was going to take on Wall Street, his chief economic advisor, Gary Cohn, is the former president of Goldman Sachs, one of the major financial institutions that pay billions of dollars in fines for their illegal activity. That's really draining the swamp. Needless to say, I did not hear President Trump say one word about another campaign promise that he made to the American people, and that was to reinstate the Glass-Steagall Act. Now, that's a little bit about what Trump did not say tonight. Let me just say a few words about what he did say. The truth is that some of what President Trump said tonight, it sounds good on the surface. But it doesn't sound so good if you dig just a little deeper beneath the surface. President Trump told us that we need to invest $1 trillion in our infrastructure, in our crumbling infrastructure, to create millions of new jobs. And you know what? He is absolutely right. That's something that I have been working on for years. But the specifics of the financing plan that he has provided us so far are absolutely wrong. We cannot rebuild our infrastructure by providing billions of dollars in tax breaks to Wall Street and large corporations. Donald Trump said tonight that we need to promote clean air and clean water. And to be very honest with you, because I was only a few feet away from the president, I had a difficult time not laughing out loud when he said that. Because on this very, very day, he signed an executive order rolling back President Obama's clean water rules and has appointed the most anti-environmental EPA administrator in our nation's history. President Trump said tonight that he wants to substantially increase funding for the Pentagon. What he didn't say tonight is that he will come up with that $84 billion in increased funding for the Pentagon by slashing programs that benefit the working people of this country, that benefit the elderly, that benefit the children, the sick, and the poor. Now here's the truth. At a time when our country spends more on defense than the next 12 countries combined, when virtually every major defense contractor has committed fraud and has had to pay fines to the federal government for their fraudulent activity, at a time when the Pentagon has buried evidence of $125 billion in bureaucratic waste, President Trump wants to increase defense spending by $84 billion over the next year and a half. And let me be very clear in stating that I think those priorities are wrong. We should not be cutting massively programs for people in need and then significantly expanding spending for the military. And let's be also clear. The $84 billion that President Trump wants to pump into the bloated Pentagon budget could, just as one example, provide free tuition at every public college and university in this country and begin to reduce the crushing burden of student debt in America. That is a choice. Do we add another $80+ billion to the Pentagon, or do we allow every qualified young American the ability to go to college tuition-free in a public college and university and substantially reduce student debt? I think the choice is clear. I think we do not need to greatly increase Pentagon spending. And while President Trump wants to slash programs that the elderly, the children, the sick, and the poorest Americans desperately rely on, He also thinks that it is a great idea to provide nearly $3 trillion in tax breaks to the top 1%. Middle class shrinking, 43 million people living in poverty, the rich doing phenomenally well, and Donald Trump wants to provide $3 trillion in tax breaks for the people on top. That is an outrage. Furthermore, President Trump claimed tonight that American corporations pay the highest tax rates in the world. We're going to have to lower substantially tax rates on large corporations. What he said is untrue. Not true. According to the Government Accountability Office, one out of five large profitable corporations pays nothing, zero in federal income tax. Today, we are losing $100 billion in revenue every year because corporations are stashing their cash in the Cayman Islands and other offshore tax havens. These corporations don't need a tax cut. They need to start paying their fair share of taxes. Tonight, President Trump once again made it clear that he plans on working with Republicans in Congress who want to repeal the Affordable Care Act, throw 20 million Americans off of health insurance, privatize Medicare, make massive cuts in Medicaid, raise the cost of prescription drugs for seniors, eliminate funding for Planned Parenthood, while at the same time, he wants to give yet another massive tax break to the wealthiest Americans, which is what would happen if the Affordable Care Act were repealed. As he did during his campaign, Donald Trump claimed that he would bring down the cost of prescription drugs. A few weeks ago, he even said that the pharmaceutical industry was, quote, getting away with murder, end quote. But if Donald Trump really wanted to take on the pharmaceutical industry, he would have told his Republican friends in the House and the Senate to pass legislation which I introduced today with 20 senators, allowing Americans to import safe, low-cost medicine from Canada. We should not have to pay the highest prices in the world for the medicine we use. Since the beginning of this year, we have seen unprecedented grassroots energy from Maine to California. Last week, at Republican town hall meetings across the country, and at more than 150 rallies that took place from coast to coast, the American people sent a clear message about what they expect from Congress. As a result, the Republicans are getting very, very worried. They're not so cocky anymore about simply repealing Obamacare. And they should be worried because the American people are standing up. And what they are saying loudly and clearly is, no, you're not going to repeal the Affordable Care Act. No, you're not going to destroy it. You are going to improve it. And in my view, what we must be doing right now is not only defending the Affordable Care Act, not only improving the Affordable Care Act, we have got to move forward to join the rest of the industrialized world and guarantee health care to all people as a right, not a privilege. We must go forward towards a Medicare for all single payer program. But defeating these attempts to destroy the Affordable Care Act transfer even more of our nation's wealth to Donald Trump and his billionaire friends. action yet. We need your action. Only together.
YouTube live event that we do, right? And I do that on purpose. That's my way of crediting all of the people that actually did the real work, put all this stuff together so that we can talk about it, right? The journalists, the videographers, the reporters, this is they're the people that bring this news to us. And that takes a lot of work. So please click on those links, share those, read those articles in full, because all I really do is give you guys, you know, the gist of what's going on, right? And this, I just want to point out to everybody really quick that you know, this is standard U.S. government bullshit right here, propaganda. I didn't even watch the speech, just so you guys know. I didn't watch the speech. I wanted to have a pleasant evening. I didn't want to listen to him blather. I can't listen to the guy talk, and I certainly didn't want to hear him tell us why we need to spend $54 billion more dollars. You know, they're not. That doesn't even count the $1.2 trillion that we're investing in new nuclear stuff. New nukes. $1.2 trillion. This was an Obama-issued thing, for all of you who are going to say, Obama did that. Yes, Obama did that. $1.2 trillion to polish off our nuclear arsenal because, you know, I don't know why. Why would you? It's ridiculous, you know? So really, almost $2 trillion in defense spending between an Obama initiative and Trump's new initiative. It's insane. It's absolutely insane. It just is just mind-numbingly insane. Trump just asked for $1 trillion. In what? Because I know he asked for $54 billion. Did he have another thing come out? I mean, whatever. It's ridiculous. We're going to have the largest. We have the largest military ever. Now we're going to have this even bigger penis extension. I mean, who thought? You didn't think you could get bigger, and we've got it bigger. We're going for the whatever that dildo was, the Konex or whatever it was called. I can't even remember the one. We're going for that in our military. We want to have the biggest dildo ever. Anyway, I had to bring it around to dick jokes somehow. I had to. We're gonna move through some stuff really quick. Rubio, you want to talk about effective ground game. Rubio was asked to leave Tampa office over disruption from weekly protests. That's badass. The people that own the lease on the building, because all they care about is somebody's leasing the building. They don't give a shit that it's Marco Rubio, right? Business. Profit. And they're losing money. People are like, we're going to leave if you don't get the protests away from our building. Because there's other people in this office building. So Marco Rubio now has to find a new place to go. Because he gets protested constantly. Why? Because he's a piece of shit and he needs to get voted out. He's spineless. So that's ground game. That's ground game actually having some serious effect. You think Marco enjoys going to work every day now? No. Did Marco enjoy going to work before when it was asleep Americans and nobody gave a fuck? Yeah. Does Marco hate his job now? Yeah. See how this works? This is, you know, this is a technique. It's fear and intimidation technique that we can use against our own employees. You know, the federal government can do the same with us, fear and intimidation with the badges and guns that choose to collaborate with our government against people. But we get to do that too. It's called voting these assholes out. It's showing up at their office and protesting. So thank you, everybody in Florida, in Tampa, who's been relentless because consistency matters. Right? It's just a beautiful thing. $1 trillion for infrastructure. Oh, thank you, you guys. Get that blow up of Trump out of camera range. You guys really don't want that there, really? Is it that bad? It was a gift from Germany. I can't, you know.
Yeah.
I want to include it in the set with everything. I'm sorry.
And he stays as long as 45 stays in office, or it loses hair.
There you go. There you go. It's yet another reason to podcast this. For podcasters, you don't have to look at the Trump blow-up doll. That's so much better for everybody. Yes, Obama started the new arms. I know. Look, Obama, anybody still defending Obama at this point, one, it's a waste of your energy. Two, we all know the truth. Three, let's move on. Just going to move on. All right, move on. All right. And
we're moving on. Good article, ground game. Cynthiana Matthews, one of the volunteers in VTV, Slack, and she's talking about the choices the reps in Ohio have made. Seems like two of the reps chose to go golfing. One of the reps chose to have a town hall. So to summarize, two of the reps are going to lose their jobs, and one of the reps may keep his job. And this article describes all that beautifully. And people came out in Ohio to these town halls. They created town hall events. People didn't show up. Some of them did. This is a perfect example of what's going on in Marco Rubio's area. It's happening in Ohio. It's happening everywhere. This is Awake America. It's an absolutely beautiful, wonderful thing to see. It's passive. They're not violent, but it's direct. They're writing up their employees every time they have a town hall and those employees don't show up. Every time they have a protest and those employees don't address that, they're writing them up. And I want to show you something that's actually several days old that I totally forgot about. And this really does summarize the disconnect between our representatives and us. And this is what we're really trying to explain. This is Joni Ernst, right? She was the pig castrating, shotgun-toting Republican congressperson in Iowa, Republican. And she's very upset that she now has actual constituents showing up at her office complaining about things and letting her know what they think. This summarizes it right here. Ernst, Iowa protesters not really there to listen. She says Senator Joni Ernst says Thursday she's glad people are paying attention to their government, but hopes they will begin to pose thoughtful questions and listen. And Quinn P. Simmons titled this perfectly. Says, I think Ernst is confused on how these things work. You are there to listen. That's the difference. Ernst doesn't get it. We want you to shut up and listen, employee. We're done listening to your shit. Wherever you are, whoever you are, in whatever state role, in whatever federal role, doesn't matter. It's time for you to shut up and listen to the citizens who pay your fucking wage. That's what we're saying. And we're doing it really nicely right now. If you think we're being violent, you have no fucking idea. We're not even there yet, folks. So, 2018, we start the mass deportation of illegal politicians from our government. Find and replace. So that's what we're doing right now. Joni Ernst is indicative of the disconnect. Oh, man. John, put your Bernie t-shirt on Trump. Okay, I could do that. I could put the Bernie t-shirt on Trump and do that.
No? No Bernie t-shirt for rubber dummy.
Do you think that's sacrilege?
Yes.
Okay. All right, well, we'll talk about that. We'll consider that. I don't want to offend Germany. I don't want to get into trouble. We've already pissed off so many people about so many things. Poor politicians, why is everybody yelling at me? Yeah, I know, Melissa. They're like, I don't understand. I wasn't told I'd have to actually listen to people. I was told I'd have a podium and money. That's basically what the... Oh, and they're saying he can't wear a non-mask either. You guys, no, nobody likes that idea. Okay, we're going to go. What is this? Eco-scientists in Tokyo... What, Markus?
Get over it.
Get over it. Eco, I was about to read whatever you were saying, science-y. I was trying to understand that. It says, Tokyo Institute of Technology have identified unique lysophatic acid? I can't understand. Take me as being central enzymes for... No, you need to synthesize whatever the hell is that into something that makes sense for me. Did you bring that down? Thus uncovering the mechanisms of biofuel production in microalgae. Oh, great. There we go. Thank you. So what I think Eco is saying is that they have uncovered the mechanisms of biofuel production in microalgae. There were certain microalgae we were able to do that anyway, but now they've uncovered the key, which should mean it should be a lot easier to do that without you, which is great. We should be making fuel from algae. We should be making fuel from all sorts of things. We could power trucks with it. All sorts of things. Anyway. He looks too much like the real Trump. No, he doesn't. He doesn't look anything like the box cover I was expecting. Trump doesn't smile like that. We don't see Trump smile like that. It's an enzyme. Awesome. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Appreciate that. He would agree to a long red tie. Ashley. Oh, yeah. Jay is talking about MoveOn.org. All right. Anyway, moving on. Because I want to get to some things. There's some important things. We're running out of time here. So, I said I was going to say something exciting about I can't even think of what it's called. Truth Against the Machine. Thank you. Sorry about that. Truth Against the Machine. Here's the deal. Z sent me an email yesterday that I didn't even catch because I'm just too busy. And basically somebody who wanted to do an interview. I need to do this interview, and I need somebody to put together, you know, like they do interviews on Skype, so I can interview this person. And Z forwarded to me and said, can you make this happen? I'm like, absolutely, that's what we do. That's what this system is for, right? So there's a whole other way that I didn't even think about utilizing this system in collaboration with somebody else. Is if somebody can arrange the production, right? We've got a reporter who's going to interview. They've got their shit together. They know what to ask. We've got an interviewee who's ready to go. We schedule a time. I've got new graphics on the way, which is what I'm going to show you guys. Ashley Terry's making on some new graphics. And we schedule a time, and boom, we have an interview. That interview can be taken, given back to Z. They chop it up into segments. It'll be up in a whole lot of things. I mean, that's fantastic, because that's the service. The thing that I can't do is coordinate that shit. The thing that I can't do is take the time to do the research to be the host and the producer, right? So if other people are doing that and saying, hey, John, you know, this person, connect, pick a time, right? That's even more of a distributed media network than I was thinking of in the first place. It's so fucking powerful. It's got me all excited about it, yeah. Right? Yeah. So, this is good. This is good shit, right? It's good shit. That's, all right, so moving on. And here we're going to look at that. I wanted to show you the graphic. Look at the graphic here. So, this is Ashley's, for our new media network, which is Uphill Media. And I'm just going to throw this out here right now. We're looking for a tagline. All right. Mm-hmm. Uphill Media is referencing of... let Ashley explain it to you. But it's the, you know, well, I'll show you the logo. Just not get too much into the symbolism of it, but I just will show you the logo. Here we go. So watch. This is the logo animation, long version. And we've just put Uphill all the way down there. I don't know if we're going to keep that like that, whatever. But that was Ashley's suggestion there. That's the new logo. We got lower thirds. Ashley's making great lower thirds, and he's making a background. And keep in mind, everybody, Ashley has his own Patreon, and he's trying to do the same thing that I'm doing and pay bills, and anybody that can help him out there would be fantastic. I'm in a better place thanks to you guys already, so anybody who comes to the show, sees the show that isn't already a patron or would like to become a patron, go to patreon.com, look for Ashley Terry. Ashley, if you can, you should drop your link in there, and I just wanted to set that up. So we'll be improving the quality of the shows, and hopefully we'll be working with Truth Against the Machine to facilitate these kinds of interviews. We've got one coming up with a lovely lady named Michelle, who's done some really cool things with the community, and we're gonna we're working on setting that up. That should be, we had that planned for Saturday. All right, so Saturday at 10:30. But I'm going to talk to Ashley. Maybe we do something different. Because he just suggested something to me. But we'll see. Anyway, I'm glad you like the logo, guys. Pretty cool. Uphill Media. There you go. Sisyphus. Yeah, exactly. More Farrar. It's a Sisyphus reference. Exactly. Yeah, you guys know more about that than I do. All right. Moving on. There's a link in the description of the YouTube event to this. I want you guys to click it and fill it out, because this is insane. This is another representative that doesn't quite get it. So dissent is patriotic. That's what we believe. This is why for months we've been showing up to congressional offices, calling every day, writing letters, emails, postcards, and more. And it's why our members took part in town halls and rallies across the state this week. or last week during the congressional recess, including a 500-plus person rally in Greenfield, Wisconsin, this is, and 150-plus in Wausau, complete with empty chairs for and a large cardboard cutout of Senator Ron Johnson. Okay. So, Ron Johnson is their representative. They did what's happening across the country, and they went and had a town hall, and he wasn't there. And they did a cardboard cutout, and they've been showing up at his office, and they've been persistent, they've been calling him, they've been doing what a woke America does, what people engaged in their democracy do. They go to their reps, and they say, you've been doing a shitty job. Because that's what most of them are doing these days, shitty jobs, because we've been not monitoring our public servants, right? They serve. It's their job. So here's what the letter goes on to say, and what do people who come to our actions get? A cease and desist letter. And there's a link to click, and you can read the full letter. This is from the senator's office, signed staff. Senator Johnson is trying his best not to hear our concerns about the future of health care, about the future of our country, and the fate of our families. There's another congressional recess coming up, and the ACA hasn't been repealed yet. Join us in saying, we will not cease and desist. So they created this petition so they can show him. And I think everybody should just sign it, even though you're not in Wisconsin. I signed it. To say, fuck you. Here's 200,000 people that say, we will not cease and desist. First of all, it's your job to hear their concerns. How dare you tell them they can't do it? Basically, it says, he will not speak with this group. Citizens Action, a Citizen Action of Wisconsin, they represent themselves as a group. You don't speak to this group. It's you can't say that. You don't have the right to say that, dude. You're an employee, Johnson. And we're going to get rid of your ass. This is all we need is a test. We'd like to speak with you, employee. How many employees would last in a job anywhere if that's what they said? Fuck you. I don't want to talk to you. I want to get back to work. I mean, that doesn't work that way. You know? Or in many of these guys' cases, I've got to go golfing. Or I've got to go meet with people that want to give me money. And it's the people that give me money that I'll do things for. That's basically the dividing line. Anyway. Stock posts, what are we talking about? How the supporters were coming in buses? Now remember, guys, these days they're showing IDs. And if they are busing people in, good. Seriously, good. I'm sure the Tea Partiers did that shit too. Alright, moving on. We're at Marcus's time here. We're totally not going to make it here for time, but that's okay. We're going to cut close. Marcus wants to talk about, this is from Der Spiegel, although it's giving me this crazy advertising bullshit. I don't even know what this is. The Germans, I guess, this is their version of regime change. The hoax that brought the World Cup to Germany. You want to explain what the hell's going on with this, Marcus?
Yeah, that's right. Well, I wrote about it because it concerns my favorite party, the party I'm a member of, and it is called, as you know, Die Partei.
Yes, yes.
And the party leader is Mr. Martin Sonneborn. And before he was the party leader, he was the chief editor of the German satire magazine Titanic.
Oh, wow, okay.
And yes, and he is known for satire and doing stupid stuff. And this time, he went a bit too far in the public opinion. It was a very big scandal here in Germany for several weeks.
Really?
Yeah. It was the press, the yellow press in front, were absolutely aggressive against them, and they were really pissed off about it. Because you got to know that our representation, when it came to the election, it was only between South Africa and Germany. And the delegation of Germany, led by Franz Beckenbauer, who was a famous football star here in Germany and a so-called angel-like being, and he was a guy, or he is a guy, who was considered to be a lucky guy. Everything he touches would be gold. He became world champion as a player and later as a coach of Germany. And he had a very great career, and his task was to get the World Cup to Germany in 2006. And of course, he built a big delegation, and they
They visited lots of places in the world, and they made propaganda or public relations for the games here in Germany. So when
No, go ahead, go on.
When it came to the election day the night before, Sonneborn, who knew that the draft situation right now, and only the chairman of the FIFA, of the Federation of the World Soccer, would decide. He would have the final voting on this, and everybody knew that he would prefer to give it to South Africa. So in this night before the election, Sonneborn and some of his colleagues sat in Berlin in the office, and they were thinking what to do. And then they had the excellent idea after a few beers to send some faxes to the hotel where the voters were placed the night before. And they sent the faxes. They sent I think it was 7 faxes. One of them went to the U.S. member who was in this hotel, and one went to Jack Dempsey from New Zealand. And it was made very, very urgent, and the hotel servants went and pushed it under the door that night. It was about 2 or 3 in the morning. And in the facts, it was completely ridiculous. They offered him, and they said they count on his vote, on the, and they want to give him a little present. And it was about German ham and some bottles of beer, original German cuckoo's clock, and so on. It was completely bullshit. And the next. Okay, the faxes were there, and the guys read them, and the next day it came to the election, and it was Jack Dempsey, the guy from New Zealand, who decided not to vote, because he said to the press later, because the pressure got too high on him. Everybody was trying to persuade him to vote for South Africa or Germany, and then he said, and then in the middle of the night, there came a fax, and this broke my neck. Then I decided not to vote. And this missing vote, because New Zealand was supposed to vote for South Africa, led to then Germany won the World Cup Championship 2006 in Germany. And when this came out, it was a big scandal, not only in Germany, because every soccer fan was pissed about it, you know. And the funny thing was, the Bild Zeitung, which is the yellow press here in Germany, they in their newspaper, they published the telephone number of the Titanic editors. And Martin Sonneborn was in the office, and he cut all the calls, and he made a product out of it and sold it by Amazon. You can find it on YouTube. Angry callers who called the chief editor and blamed them, and they were aggressive. You should be hanged. You are a piece of shit, and you didn't deserve to live in Germany. You know all this national crap. And he was always polite and friendly and thanked for the input and asked them stupid questions also. And it is so funny to listen to. Unfortunately, it is of course only in German. But this was the big, big scandal. And the more funny thing is, in 2015, it came out that the games were really bought.
Right,
the German delegation.
right. There's the whole corruption of FIFA. Yeah. Anyway, but that's
yeah.
I gotta say that this is hilarious. That it just for Americans right now. Imagine if this were happening with the NFL. I know none of you give a shit about soccer. So just when Markus says football, just think NFL and think what happens is the city that gets the Super Bowl game, and they just lost their Super Bowl game, to give you reference. All right.
Well, everybody who cannot understand this, they should go to YouTube. There's a John Oliver video about the FIFA.
Oh, yeah.
It's very, very funny to see. And as I said, it is a religion here in Germany. Football is more than
right.
Europe and the world, you know. This is why we're so euphoric about it.
I know. It's over there. And you guys take shit very seriously. It's like the driver's license. I mean, if you're going to fine people thousands of dollars for driving without a license, if people are like,
like, it's dishonorable. I would never drive without a license. You fuck you. I would never do that. You know, I mean, you guys totally. So I can see with soccer, where you guys are like, with football, you guys would be like, no way. No. Right? So I'm guessing now at this point with the giant scandal in 2015, what happened back then, kind of like whatever. I thought it was funny.
We have some slides. Maybe you can show them quickly.
Oh, you have slides even, yeah.
61 or 62?
All right. Yeah, give me a second here. Let's pull those up. 61. I'm sorry, Markus. I didn't know you'd even made
62. No problem at all.
All right.
No. It was 6. No. It's the wrong one.
There you go. There.
This is the right one, yes. And there on the left is the facts, the original facts you sent.
Oh, nice.
And it was reported, and there's one quote of one of the top secretaries of the German Soccer Federation: the limits of satire have been far exceeded.
That's the German way to put it. The limits of satire have been exceeded?
Yeah.
I didn't know satire had a limit. Then we go into black comedy. That's where it goes. It goes from satire to black comedy.
Yeah, indeed.
Oh, you guys are talking about Lee Camp in comparisons to John Stewart. I have to agree.
Yeah, I guess soccer is not that thing.
No. But this was funny, guys. I know. But see, you guys, your nation's in a lot of different places. You can do this kind of stuff and cause corruptions. We're too busy blowing up the world to, you know. Sorry, but that's funny. Thank you for that. Maybe you could try that with Trump. Offer him some gold sausages or some, you know, change your official German beer label to Trump or something. I don't know. You could do something like that.
I don't think this is possible. Oh, yeah, Kölsch maybe. The Cologne stuff they're drinking there.
There you go.
In the city, we don't like it. This is
there you go. Well, thank you for that report, Markus. Thank you for letting us know about that. I had no idea. I did know you guys took your soccer that seriously, though. Or your football. Okay. All right, where are we at? I had some things I was going to cover. I think I'm gonna blow them off, mainly because time. I was going to go through some deep shit, but I think I'll save the deep shit for another day. Yeah, I had it on the list, deep shit, grief, and empathy. I'm not going to get through that at 11:51 with climate science and Sessions, climate and science and Sessions and music story time. I gotta get through all of that shit. So no, we will do the heavy deep shit tomorrow or something and go that direction. So all right, here we go. And I, you know what, Joanne, I am, you have a crush on Jimmy Dore. I like Jimmy Dore's style of comedy too. I think he could use a better production. Not that they're doing a bad job on Jimmy Dore. I just think he could expand his production. And it would be really cool, right? I've seen him do like on stage stuff in LA. And so moving on. Where's it go? Really quick. So we talked about the permafrost and the fact that it's melting. That article's in there if you want to look at it. Everybody, massive permafrost thaw documented in Canada pretends huge carbon release. Not just Canada; it's happening all over the place, and it's bad. It's not good. It's bad. That's worse. That's still worse. Right there, that's worse than continuing to eat cows. Just to everybody that's been sending me messages lately about, are you vegan? And we need to stop eating meat and whatever. I agree with sequestering methane from our cattle industries, from our meat industries. I agree with completely changing the way we do our meat industries. However, it is not going to solve climate change if we just stop eating meat all of a sudden. We need to do biomass reclamation. And so, yeah. But I know you'll never get me to go vegan. I'm an omnivore, and I will honor my body in that sense. I'll deal with the relationship with the meat. I'd rather do that, right? So anyway, moving on, just talking about that, that's a lot of CO2, a lot more CO2 than coming out of cows' asses. Here's something really, really cool. While we are spending most of our time on coal, I guess we're going to revive the coal industry, or try to, which is really dumb. And we're going to build more weapons because that's what we do. China is doing this. When people say, well, we can't do that, or it's too big, or it's going to take too long, or too much money. So China has said they're investing $363 billion by 2020 into renewables. They understand that coal, which is what they've been using, has kind of been killing their peoples, kind of ruining their chances at having beautiful stuff in cities. We've seen the smog. We've seen how crazy it is over there, right? That's what's going to happen in our states, the places that go back to coal, the idiots that actually vote for that shit. Okay. But this is what's cool. They started this in 2013. 4 million solar panels. 5 years later, that's the mass from space. That's a lot of fucking solar panels. That's huge. Imagine if we'd started doing something like that in a place like Nevada or Utah or Arizona, where we've got all sorts of desert land that's flat and gets pounded by the sun constantly. God, just imagine if we'd spent some money on that. It'd be just awesome. Be awesome. Here's a... This is kind of cool. It's a time lapse. I guess they started in 2013 with those, and a lamb. Here it is today. Yes, it's going to take time. Thank gosh we have Tesla's gigafactories to help produce these things, and he wants to put more of those around the world. All we got to do, folks, is kick out the old white people, the government, really. It comes down to it. It's kick out the old greedy white men, mostly. It's 90% of the problem we got going on right now, and replace them with us. And then we, too, can have 4 million solar panels. That's the way it goes. You're buying another 500 watts of solar panels? I still haven't talked to the wife about the offer from Velocity Solar. I got to go through all that stuff. Crystal reviewed it for me, said it wasn't bad. I haven't even agreed to it yet. I got to have more conversation. Anyway, 11:56. We're gonna end this damn show on time. I swear to God, we're gonna end this on time today. You're right, EcoSuture. It would take no time at all if we acted like Manhattan Project. We mobilized like it was World War II. We'd be done in a year. We'd be freaking done in a year. If we had to bring all of our industries online, if we did what we did in World War II to mobilize and converted our factories to do this, we'd be done in a fucking year. We got that kind of power and might. Take every goddamn soldier that's doing, I don't know what they're doing right now, put a shovel and in their hands and teach them how to put up solar panels, and we'd be done. It's exactly the opposite of what the greedy old white men want to do, which is why we have to find and replace the greedy old white men and other people that act like greedy old white men, because it really comes from Depression-era greed, Depression-era thinking, and it's indoctrination from an era when people didn't have a lot, but people didn't have a lot because the government was corrupt. That's why. Still is. Here. Jeff Sessions. Jeff Sessions pissing me off every fucking day, it seems. Jeff Beauregard Sessions. Listen to what this insane man thinks. This is an old, greedy white man. Old, racist, greedy white man. And this is what he thinks of marijuana. I think it's the best idea ever. I want to do exactly what Jeff thinks is terrible. Let's do this. Let's hope it runs. Here, let's rewind. Let's read it. He's been clicked there.
We saw so many lives destroyed by drug abuse.
Destroyed?
And I think the drugs today are more powerful and more addictive, and they can destroy even more lives. Young people have their lives destroyed. I, as you know, am dubious about marijuana. As states, I guess, can pass whatever laws they choose, but I'm not sure we're going to be a better, healthier nation that if we have marijuana being sold at every corner grocery store. I just don't think that's going to be good for us. And we'll have to work our way through that. I see a line in the Washington Post today that I remember from the 80s. This one was, if you smoke, you know, marijuana is a cure for opiate abuse. Give me a break.
I won't give you a break, you dumb, ignorant fuck. It absolutely is. This is the kind of fucking ignorance I'm talking about, everybody. I can't even listen to the rest of the thing. He's equating marijuana to opiates, and they are
not the fucking same. And anybody with half a goddamn neuron who's read any kind of a recent science journal on cannabis, on opioid addiction, which is the big issue in this country, would know that they are not the same. Everybody with half a fucking brain in their head knows they're not the same. Except for Jeff Beauregard Sessions, who happens to be the AG of this country and is now going to send his federal goon squad out to states where it's fucking legal. And I welcome him down here. Don't ask me why I'm so violent about the whole idea that he wants to come take my weed, but I'm about that the way teabaggers were about guns. Don't you dare tell me what the fuck I can plant and grow in my ground. Fuck you, Jeff. You have no goddamn idea what you're talking about cannabis. You're ignorant, and just like most old, greedy white men, you're not interested in updating your information set. You know, it's what John Stewart said the other day. 70-year-old cranky white men aren't really going to learn new things, and they're not really interested in learning new things. That's why we got to get these fuckers out of our goddamn government as fast as possible. And it's not just greedy old white men. It's people that think that way, right? Because we got
And I can tell you what is on his mind. He thinks that all of those guys who are storming their representatives in the town halls and are angry with them, they are on the killer drug marijuana.
Yes.
This would be the next scenario he presents.
Of course. They're stoners. They're violent, yeah. The violent Dems.
Violent stoners, yes.
Which is bullshit. I hope he dies soon, Kevin Hendricks. I really do. I've said that for a long time. I got no empathy, sympathy, anything for Jeff Sessions other than he's a human being, and I guess I owe him respect for that. But I hope to God he... And we're back. I again, technical shit. Have no idea why it's doing this. I hope Livestream sends an update really soon. Yeah, and it could be just Comcast fucking with me too. Who knows? Good night, NSA. I thought that was hilarious. Everybody, we're moving on to story time. I can't go without the music. Story time. I have this great tune, and so if you guys stick around just for 2 seconds, we do this, and we will be doing expanded story time with stories from Markus. All right, because I have a limited set of rock and roll snobbery, really, and Markus has a different set of rock and roll snobbery. So we're going to combine those sets. Yes. And we'll get Laura live and good on that when we do the new show. But you guys have been a fantastic. Thank you so much for coming by today and having a conversation with me and Markus. It's really wonderful to have you here. And
thank you.
Yes, the air, Markus. So it says, yeah, everybody. Thank you. And
thank you very much for watching us.
Yes. And I'm setting up the song. Here's music story time. It's not Come On Eileen, although that song, I remember that song. It was very overplayed on American pop radio
It was.
A lot. It's just a lot. I can't even get, I was thinking about that with, oh, come on, CPU, don't do it to me again. I'm watching it. I don't know what the hell it's doing. There we go. It's got just weird stuff going on today. Anyway, the last song is really for you guys. I know things look shitty. I know that we can all have disagreements on how bad things are and how much the DNC can affect things and how much the people in power can affect us at the lower level and how much time we have before the whole thing just falls apart and goes to hell in a handbasket, whether it's environmentally or politically or whatever it happens to be. Things simultaneously look really shitty and really good. All right? And, Whatever you got going on right now in your life, just remember that there are other people out there in the world. This doesn't invalidate what you got going on with your life. But every time I think about something that bothers me, when I'm like, man, you know, I got a backache, my arm aches, or you know, my hand, my whole arm is all messed up, and I complain about it. White people problem. Right? I think about the fact that right now, what I'm fighting for in this country is for people to have the right to even be here. For people to have the right to not be deported, to not have their family separated. I'm fighting for the right now for people who are being told they can't come into this country or are being detained illegally, without any fucking reason. I'm fighting for that. I'm fighting for the fact that there are people in other countries right now that are suffering massive climate damage, environmental damage from climate change that we caused. So when I think about my problems, when I think about how shitty things are, I guess what this really is saying, somewhere else in the world, things are worse. And that's not a positive statement. What it is a reminder of what we've got to do and what's at stake. And we are making progress. And 2018 is the first marker for making incredible progress. We will be able to do so much in 2018 if we focus on what we're doing right now to get ready for 2018. And I just want to say, don't give up. Things are shitty. Things are probably going to get shittier. Whether it's from weather devastating the United States or the political scenario, deportations, there's just things look, I get it, things look bad, but don't give up. You have friends. Don't give up. We're going to get through this. We're going to make it happen. We're going to change the world. And the song that I put with that is called Don't Give Up. Imagine that. But it's Peter Gabriel and Kate Bush. And I'm so glad that this song is able to be played. It's an incredible song, and the video, I don't remember the video, but it's just the two of them singing and holding each other, which is very touching and very odd for a video of the time. But the words, if you click on the link and look at the words, they're all in this video, guys. And kind of think about it. It just sounds like a story that could be half of America right now. It's things are shitty, but don't give up. We'll see you guys tomorrow on Awake.
No fight left, or so it seems.
screams of mountains out here. I've changed my face, I've changed my name, but no one wants you when you're loose.
Don't give up, cause you have friends. Don't give up, you're not beat yet. Don't give up, I know you can make it good.
Though I saw it all around, never thought that I could be affected. Thought that we'd be lost to go. It is so strange the way things turn. Drove the night to warn my home, the place that I was born, on the lakeside. As daylight broke, I saw the earth, the trees had burned down to the ground.
Don't give up, you still have us. Don't give up, we don't need much of anything. Don't give up, cause someone has a place where we can go. Let's go ahead. You worry too much. It's gonna be alright. When times get rough, can't fall back on us. Don't give up. Please don't go.
Got to walk on again. I can't take anymore. Gonna stand on that bridge. Keep my hands back below. Whatever may come, I won't. That river's flowing. That river's flowing. Moved on to another town. Tried hard to settle down. For every job, so many men. So many men no one needs.
Don't give up, cause you have friends. Don't give up, you're not the only one. Don't give up, no reason to be ashamed. Don't give up, you still have us. Don't give up now, we're proud of who you are. Don't give up, you.
Import. That and my tricep. They were advancing. Okay.